There we go. Go ahead.
All right. So I just want to thank to the organizing committee, especially Hannah McDonald. And as, let me just see if I can. As you may or may not know, since 2006, we have developed ChamGUI as a cyber infrastructure to generate various actually molecular simulation systems and input files for major simulation programs. Just for your information, Tinker input generation will be available next week. In this slide, I just want to point out two things. The first one is we are actually spending a lot of time communicating users to help their actually research. And the second, you may notice this quantum jump last year in terms of citation due to pandemic. But luckily, I guess thanks to many of you, so we expect to have more citation. So I'm just curious to see how far we can grow. Okay. So I will start with some membrane builder stuff. So just to give you a history, 2007, we actually released our first membrane builder with three lipid types. And at that time, we only support homogeneous lipid bilayers and protein membrane complex. In 2009, in collaboration with Jeff Clauder, we expand membrane builder to have actually 35 lipid types. And now we start to actually, at that time we started to support membrane only systems and heterogeneous bilayers. It took us quite some time to expand membrane builder to include biologically actually important lipid types, such as phosphoinositols, cardiolipin, sphingolipid, bacterial lipid, and various sterols. At this stage, we thought that one could build quite more realistic biological membranes. What was lacking at that time is glycolipids, like a glycodetergent, glycolipid, and GPI anchor, that some protein actually anchor to GPI, and also lipopolysaccharide from various gram-negative bacteria. With this addition, now one can even build various actually outer membrane, bacterial outer membrane, gram-negative bacterial outer membrane, membranes with or without actually proteins. So 21, we have over 600 different lipid types. And we also have diacylglycerol, and we also have triacylglycerol that are necessary for lipid drumline modeling. Very recently, we add this ionizable cationic lipid and pegylated lipid with any number of actually PEG units. What does that mean? Now you can actually build the lipid nanoparticle and you can actually examine what components are good for lipid nanoparticle formulation for genetic drug discovery. Probably most of us have this lipid nanoparticle through a COVID-19 vaccine. So membrane builder not only actually allow you to model the systems in bilayer, but you can also have a various actually nanodisc, micelles, and even vesicles. So it can be used for wide actually modeling and simulation of membrane systems. Now let me move on. It is still quite headache when you look at this carbohydrate glycans attached to protein or maybe hanging around the your PDB structure. It is quite difficult to actually recognize what kind of sugar types you have. It is extremely actually still difficult to know what are the linkages between these sugars. So in 2011, Sun Hwan Jo, he was a graduate student in my lab, actually developed this very acute and novel and amazing actually a tool, a glycan reader. So using just coordinate information and graph representation, he could initially first actually identify which ring structures might be a potential carbohydrate. So for example, you can consider one oxygen and five carbons make a ring that could be a potential carbohydrate. And depending on the orientation of oxygens, then you can recognize, you can actually determine the glycan types, sugar types, and using the anomeric carbon connection to the neighboring actual sugars, you can define these linkages. This was done in 2011. I think it's still amazing, and he was really ahead of time. It took us really long time to expand glycan reader now to actually automatically detect most carbohydrate in the PDB, even their actually chemical modification. When I say detect, it's not simply knowing what are there. It is actually building a model and actually build a simulation ready systems you know, that you can actually start your simulation. So I think it's quite remarkable. The problem in the glyco-conjugate simulation, especially a glycoprotein simulation, is this carbohydrate, a so-called N-glycan, or O-glycans. In the PDBs, most of them are truncated. You may know now by SARS-CoV-19, actually, a SARS spike protein. So to expand our actually modeling capability, so that given protein structure and glycosylation sites and the glycan sequence, for each glycan sequence, we use a glycan fragment database. We actually build based on the older glycan structures in the PDB, and then we optimize the orientation. So by this time, 2019, so the glycan reader and modeler was not popular because there are not actually many people are doing a glyco actually a protein or glycoconjugate modeling and simulation. We did not prepare pandemic, but now you know that these carbohydrates are important for spike protein modeling and even for HIV envelope protein modeling, for protein, you know, to understand structure and dynamics of this important protein. And because of this, probably people now you know, realize that, oh wow, glycan reader and modeler can really actually enable them to study and model and simulate glycoconjugate glycoconjugates, so that we see more usages of glycan reader and models and more citations. So let me move. So the multi-component assembler, I would say, will be the final destination of all the modeling capabilities in CHAM GUI. So in this very simple case, you can actually model the assembly of different actually proteins in different concentration with and without membranes. What is more important, one can build various nanomaterial from nanomaterial modelers, so that you know, one can use multi-component assembler to build a system with the nanomaterial and proteins, even try to build a supported actually lipid bilayer. And you know, we are eating actually one credit card every week, believe it or not. And then the concerns are more about the micro plastics or nanoplastic, and you know, possibly their interactions with biomolecules. So Yeol-Gyo Cho, he actually developed very nice polymer builder in CHAM GUI Now you can imagine you can build polymers actually through polymer builder and have them together with actually proteins to study a polymer or plastic and a protein interaction through a multi-component assembler. So far, when I say building a model, we mostly exclusively use the charm phosphate. Okay, so at the end, the model, we get a PSF, which is a topology or a file, and a simulation topology file, and the CRD, which is a coordinate. So force field converter now unifies using these two and the parameters that actually generate all other input files plus necessary actually topology and coordinate files. Through this unification, what we can do now, we can add any force field that can support the all the components in your system and the different actually program that can support any force field. So for now, obviously, the charm force field can be used for all the simulation engines that we support. And the ember force field was supported only for ember simulations. And when I say ember force field, there are many. So, you have a freedom to choose. And next week, you will see that you can generate Gromex and open input files using ember force field, including FF19SB, which was a little tricky because it has all the real actually residue-based CMAPs. We also support OPLS force field for NAMD and Gromex only because of their special treatment treatment requirement that for the 1-4 or other interactions. And then we also support, although OpenFF is designed for ember force field, it can be used for all supported MD engines. And obviously, just one click, all the system can be actually prepared with hydrogen mass repartitioning for 4 femtosecond simulations. Okay, so let me just switch gear a little bit. So this is a ligand binding site of finder and refiner. So we have developed this program called GROTHA. So this is a local alignment, actually a program that given to local protein structures, it align and it gives a score between 0 and 1. 1 is a perfect. And because we have a lot of actually protein ligand complex, so that we can build a template structures from the PDB and use these template structures and GROSA to actually predict the binding site of proteins and even design ligands for the given actually binding site. So what ligand binding site finder and refiner does, taking the input structure, then it goes through the GROSA search with the templates. Then it actually predict where might be the potential binding site. If you wanna go move more forward, and it actually generate the distance restraint based on your templates and prepare the simulation for ligand binding site refinement. So you can imagine that you have a APO structure and finding a potential binding site and template, and then you can actually generate holo-like structure as an output for the docking. And as I said, given the target binding site, we can do a fragment assembly so that we can actually design so that the ligand designer and also provide an option to change a structure, and also given the selected your ligands, you can also generate all the force field so that you'll be ready to actually simulate the complex of your protein and the ligands of new designed ligands. Okay, so this is a free energy meeting, so I should finish my talk with a free energy calculator. So in free energy calculator, we support four types of free energy calculation: absolute ligand binding, relative ligand binding, absolute ligand solvation, and relative ligand solvation. This has been through extensive collaboration with Benoit for CHARM, and Charlie is not available yet, but hopefully in the future, multi-site Lambda Dynamics, and Wei for NAMD, Yuji for Genesis, and Darren for Ember. So the workflow is very simple. So depending on your protein solution, soluble protein or membrane protein, you have one ligand at the beginning, and then you go through a solution builder or you go through a membrane builder. You set up your actually environments. Then we provide the option to create a diverse actually ligand set. And for even absolute and the relative, for the relative, we provide very primitive, or I would say, but some tools that define the path, and then we prepare all the alchemical structure for simulation. So in the just one example is, if you know all the molecules that you want to actually perturbate, you can simply upload the mol to or STD file. But if you want to do R changes, you can do a combinatorial actually structure generation through this kind of graphics. And based on the structure similarity, actually we just suggest this is the pairs that are most similar to each other. And the nice thing is these options, the selections can be actually added and deleted and modified. So you have a full power of selecting which pair you wanna actually do a free energy calculation. I'm just trying to show you just a very preliminary results that we just got from Ember. And so in Ember, there are two actually protocol, one step or unified protocol, and three steps a split protocol. So split three times longer. So this is just to give you an idea. So it takes 16 about hours to just get a one number using a single 2080 Ti using unified protocol for the about 65,000 atom systems. And we use 21 windows, and each window for 5 nanosecond, 4 femtosecond, this for split. So 21 window is a little too much, but I think for most practical application, people use 11 windows. If you say that it is using Ember, you get actually one number for eight, actually after 8 hours. So here, what we compare is within one protocol, the results are not really depends on the time step that you use. So the 4 femtosecond should be enough. And the big question is, you know, how many replicas we really need to learn to get confident of the calculated numbers. And so here we compare two different protocols. And as you may see, when we get to the about 4 replicas, I think the errors are quite small within the group, so that the numbers are actually more reliable to use for any actually comparison. Okay, so what we are doing now and expanding this base set to the older JAX benchmark sets using Unified protocol, but we are trying to actually look at all the combinations of the Ember force field to see which actually force field combination might be practically better. Okay, so I went through quickly. I'm not sure if you remember all this, but you know, in the future you will see a high throughput simulator, which is think about you do a docking and you have so many protein ligand actually dock structures, 100 to 1,000. Then this high throughput simulator will generate actually inputs for all the systems, whether they are membrane, whether they are solution systems. And we plan to add non-standard amino acid into PDB reader to automatically detect those. And once we have that, we will be in a much better position to actually do covalent ligand modeling. And obviously, enhanced sampler will be covering a lot of enhanced sampling in different programs. And we having a good discussion with Alex Disson at Michigan State University about the weighted ensemble sampler. QMMN interface would be good to have. And next year, if I go to Boston, maybe I can actually share some. And the DOI assign is our ongoing effort to make the simulation results actually reproducible so that you can imagine that you can generate the CHOMGUI DOI for the system that you generate with all the force fields and all the input. Then actually a DOI will be given so that you can use DOIs for the papers, and then anyone can actually get your system for reproducibility. And this is group, they work hard, and thanks to them and the previous and current actually funding. Thank you.
Thanks, Wonpil. It's a very nice talk. So I think we've got time for one quick question. There are a few in the Q&A window, so if you wouldn't mind answering those afterwards by typing in the box. So the question's from Kellon, and it says, would the ability to build membranes using customizable lipids be available, or would that not be a feature?
I think we, so I know that now the companies actually, they have their own lipid molecule. So we actually have that plan in mind.
Okay, brilliant. Thank you. So that brings us to the end of the session. I'd like to thank all the speakers for their great talks. So I now bring this session to a close, and we have a 15-minute break. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, everyone. Please return back here in about 15 minutes, as Rich mentioned. The next session will start at 1 p.m. Eastern time.